Come on, let's get a Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. All you can do, Baronet, come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Oh, God is good and all the time he is good, isn't he? Oh, I just want to let you know, I thank God for still being the Lamb of the living. Oh, I could have been dead and gone, sleeping in my grave, but yet God gave me a second chance. Oh, I'm still here. And it's by the grace of God. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm still here. So God. All right, I don't know what's going on with the microphone. Satan, get on back now. All right. All right. Okay, I'm going to read the scripture. It's, all right, these glasses won't get me in trouble too. All right, Ephesians 3:20 said, there will always be trials and tribulations in life. But God will carry you through every storm in your life. And God will give you strength to make it. Oh, I want to let you know, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it look like, no matter what it seem like, God is going to give you strength through it. Amen. They don't do this no more, but I feel like testifying. Can I testify for a minute? Amen. Let me see. Last year in February, I got me a new car. I bought me a Nissan Maxima. And what's going good with it? Paying my bills on time and stuff. So around November of last year, how I had my payments, I was having it coming out automatically. Around November, they stopped taking out the payments. They didn't call me, so I sure was going to call them. Amen. So around January of this year, had to do some stuff personal, and they had to run my credit or whatever. So they said, well, we see that you had a car, but it's paid in full. I said, no. I said, I just got this car last year in February. It ain't paid for. So it wasn't until last month in February I was at work, and it was kind of a busy month. And Credit Karma sent an alert to my phone. I said, I ain't got time. I'll check them later. So read the Credit Karma, and it said that my Nissan Maxima was paid 100%, paid in full. Uh-huh. And the blessing on top of that is, I got another alert a few minutes later saying the car had been removed from your credit. Don't tell me what God won't do. So when you see me dancing, don't hate, but you better appreciate mama. Uh-huh, because I don't know about y'all, but next year, I'm looking to get me a house built from the ground up. So I'm going to dance from my house from the ground up. But you know what? My granny used to sing a song every time she'd hear some good news. She'd say, didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? God told me to tell you. God told me to tell you. Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? God told me to tell you. God told me to tell you. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right, now y'all better stop. Y'all gonna get me started. All right, now. All right. Y'all stop. We got to go on. We got to go on. All right. Miss Jackie. Come here, Miss Jackie. Come on, Miss Jackie.
Right now, we give you glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for this day. God, thank you for allowing us to be here again. We ask you, bless this service. Bless each and every person in here right now. And God, we thank you for the victory in our lives, God. We thank you for what you're doing in our lives, God. And God, we give you an advanced praise with our hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, if you did it for Quay, you can do it for us. Hallelujah. How many of y'all claim a paid in full blessing? Somebody shout, paid in full. Hallelujah. Today is Palm Sunday. Palm Sunday. And this scripture says, John 12:13. They took palm branches and went to meet him, shouting, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel. It's Palm Sunday. Well, we know later on in the week, the same folks that were shouting praises unto him crucified him. 3 days later, He got up and he rose, and the choir is coming with He Rose. Y'all come on and get in with the young adult choir with He Rose. how glad that he got up with all power in his hands. Can I get all the ladies in the building to say he got up with all power? Come on, ladies. I don't hear y'all out there. Come on. All right, all right, all right. Come on, let's add both of y'all together. Come on. Come on, ladies. Cut the music down a little bit. Let me hear the ladies out there. Come on. I hear y'all, ladies. Come on, rock with us. Come on, rock with us. Let me hear you, ladies. All right, we gotta get the guys. Come on, guys.
He got up with all power. He got up.
Come here, the guys out there. Come on, guys.
He got up with all power. He got up.
Well, let's bring everybody. Everybody, come on.
He got up with all power. He got up.
Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Aren't you glad that he got up? It's a secular artist by the name of Mooney Long, and she has a song called Made For Me. It's a popular song right now. But for some reason, when I hear that song play, I think about Jesus. His body was bruised for my body. His skin ripped. Scratched for my skin. He was literally made for us. Literally made for us. Aren't y'all glad that he was made so that we may be saved? At this time, we will have an inspirational speaker by none other than Sister Sarah Coates. Y'all, give it up for Sister Sarah as she comes.
Here's Sister Sarah Coates, y'all. All righty. When Chris asked me to say something for young adult, I was like, no, I ain't no preacher. I can't say, well, I can't do all that. But, but I do have a testimony. And when I was trying to think about like a little theme for it, I kept thinking. And Kendra called us up to the altar in the morning service, and it just hit me, follow God. And so that's what I want to talk to y'all about. Now, most of y'all know I came here from a dream. Yes, really a dream. Now, the Lord said, yo, young men and women's going to see dreams. So I saw a dream. But actually, before I had that dream, and it was about MSU, I discounted myself with university. I didn't think I was going to be able to ever afford any place with the name university attached to it. So I was like, okay, God, you know, I'm going to do an associate's degree because that's what I can afford. You know, that's within my limits. That's within my bounds. Then I had another dream. And the Lord was like, girl, you are not going to have any upward advancement with your plan. And I was like, okay. Let me just do something else then. I didn't know how I was going to pay for it, but I was like, let me look at bachelor degree programs. Let me look all over the place. And at that point, I must have had the dream about MSU, and I was standing somewhere in front of the drill field or somewhere, and I was smiling from ear to ear in the dream. And I woke up, and I completely disregarded it because I didn't think it was important. And then later on, the closer I got to high school graduation, I was like, wait a minute. Maybe that dream was like God being like, hey, girl, here's your destiny. So I started looking. Didn't know how I was going to pay for anything, but I started looking. Let me try to see where I need to go. And I came up empty, and I kept the diary, actually, because I was like, Lord, what in the world? I was just going to settle. I was just going to go somewhere else. I was going to go here. Why you got this dream, and I don't know where this school is at, and I don't know how to find it. I don't know anything about it, and yet you have this dream for me. I'm like, what do I need to do? I wanted to settle so bad for something that wasn't what God had told me. But I knew that if I did that, I would completely skip whatever it was he had for me at that school. So I was not depressed, but disappointed, like, man, but I kept looking. I looked day and night. I probably should have prayed because, you know, carnal looking ain't going to find nothing that God told you. But I was looking. I was looking. And I came up empty. And one night, my mom was like, so what you going to do after high school? And I was like, I don't know. I'm going to transfer somewhere. And I told her about the dream, and I told her about the school. And I was like, I have not found this school yet, and I don't know what to do. And she said, that's funny, because I heard Mississippi State University the other day in the spirit, 2 weeks ago. And I was like, 2 weeks ago? Wait a minute. What you heard? She's like, I figured it must be for you. And I looked at so many colleges, I was kind of scarred. I was like, there ain't no Mississippi State University. That don't exist. So I looked it up. And it does exist, and it has since 1878. So I was like, okay, Lord, this is the only concrete school you've told me. I started looking at the pictures. I'm like, okay, it matches with what the dream says, so I'm going to apply. And if I apply and I get in, then I'm just going to assume it's you. Again, still don't know how I'm going to pay for any of this. Touch your neighbor, say, any of this. But I applied. The night I applied, the internet gave me so much drama. And I said, Lord, just let my application slide through anyway. And it did. And then I got the email from them saying, congrats, you're a Bulldog. I said, wait a minute, what? I was prancing around my living room, y'all. I'm a Bulldog, yeah. Still, didn't know how I was going to pay for any of it. Now I had to move from California to Mississippi, figure out rent, figure out bills, figure out all that stuff. But I was like, Lord, if you said it's going to happen, then I just got to go with you. I didn't know what I was doing. But I got a $42,000 scholarship from MSU. Amen for that. And then, because the Lord is so good, you know what now? And I thought that was enough. I'm like, okay, between that and loans, I'm good, you know? I'm tight, but I'm good, right? Last week, I got an email, and my only scholarship is from MSU General. Not from College of Business, not from accounting, not from anything. I'm an accounting major. So I got an email from the accounting school that said, congrats, you're the recipient for XYZ scholarship. I said, what? I was waiting for them to send me another email and say, we made a mistake. You are not the recipient for the scholarship. We apologize. And that email never came. So I got a whole nother scholarship, and they ain't told me what it's worth yet. But I'm like, Lord, if it's anything. Oh, Jesus. I discounted myself and I said, I can't pay for nothing. And the Lord said, yeah, you can't, I can. And so here we are today. And I just want to wrap up by saying it reminds me of Proverbs 3:6, which is, in all thy ways acknowledge him and he shall do what? Okay, y'all know it. Follow me as I follow Christ, amen.
Somebody shout, paid in full. Somebody shout, paid in full. I think it's a paid in full anointing in the place right now. Hallelujah. Anybody need anything? Paid in full. Somebody, I said paid in full. Owing nothing. I think we should give God a paid in full praise. I think we should give him a paid in full praise. Do y'all believe it? Let's take 10 seconds and give God a paid in full praise right here. Come on. We gotta praise God for that. Know this. He can do it. Car paid off. A car paid off. I want y'all to grab hands with a neighbor. Grab that neighbor hand and look them dead in the eye. And say, neighbor, I'm about to give God an advanced praise for paying it in full. Paying all of my debt off. And on the count of three, get that neighbor hand. Get out in the aisle, y'all. Come on. We're going to praise God. All right. Ready? Got that neighbor hand? Look at him real good. Say, neighbor, don't play with me. I need you. One, two, one, two, three. Come on.
Move on in service. I'm going to give you 15 more seconds to let go. Some of y'all need to let go because you're almost there. Ready? I'm going to give y'all 15 more seconds. Y'all ready? I'm going to play with it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on, come on, come on. Miracle. Any day now, I expect my blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As you take your seats, just say any day now. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Woo. Glory to God. Hey, somebody caught on to it. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This ain't no game or gimmick, but that's just who God is. And if you ain't had him do it for you, I dare you to try him. I dare you to try him. College students, don't think you can get in too much debt that God can't pull you out of it. You hear me? She got scholarships. I came here. I didn't spend a dime on college. And college paid for my apartment. Y'all, don't say what God won't do. Amen. At this time, praise the Lord. We're getting back dignified. Praise the Lord. At this time, The young adult choir is coming as we wipe our sweat, praise God, as Sister Faith Austin leads us with the bread of life, bread of heaven, sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. He is the living word. Amen. Then praise God for the young adult choir.
Come on, how many of you know that his word is true? It's living, it's alive. Amen. Amen. Bread of life. Sent down from glory, many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word. He's an awesome ruler. He's a gentle redeemer. He's God with us, the living truth, and what a friend we have in you, you. You are the living word. Help me say, sent down from glory.
A carpenter. Romans 10, 13 tells us that whosoever, whosoever, doesn't matter how high, doesn't matter how low you are, doesn't matter how unworthy you may feel, he says, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord will be saved. How many of you believe that on this morning? It doesn't matter how far you've gone, young adults, college students. I know the enemy tries to play with our mind at times and tries to call us unworthy. Yay. Glory, glory. But God says, when we call on his name, when we call on his name, when we call on the name of Jesus, hallelujah, when we call on Jesus, things begin to happen at the name of Jesus, Pastor Hawkins. So thank God for Jesus. So let's just call on his name, whatever you're going through. Believe that it is turning around for you.
Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jehovah. See, Jesus, Jesus, my provider. Waymaker, oh sweet Jesus, you are the living word. You are the living word. You are the living word. Jesus is the living word, y'all. You are the living word. Sing that. See, you are the living word. You are the living word. City, you are the living word.
There's power in his word.
You are the living word.
There's power in Jesus' name.
You are. You are the living word.
You are the living word.
Jesus, Jesus. That's what we call you. Jesus, Jesus. Oh, oh, oh. You are the living word.
Come on, will you worship the Lord? You are the living word. Oh, oh, you are the living word. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're my healer. You're my redeemer. Oh! Hallelujah. Father, we bless you now. The living word. We bless you and we praise you. And we give you glory. There's nobody like you. Nobody can do this like you do this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we call Jesus. There's healing in your name. Deliverance in your name. Power in your name. Power in your name. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We say, have your way, oh God. Forgive sin everywhere. Forgive us, Lord. Blot out the transgression. Cover in the blood. We can admit, God, we're wrong and you're right. And you said that we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us. And we bless your name now. This morning, Father, we pray for those that are sick, not well in their body. We know you to be a healer. It's in your name. Healing is in your name. It's by your stripes we're healed. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Deliverance in your name. Deliver today. And God, we praise you. We magnify you. We look to you because you're our strength. You're our help. We pray for those that are less fortunate than we are. We pray for men and women in harm's way, those that protect and serve God. We pray for them and their families. We pray for the leadership of our country, our state, our city, our community, and the leadership of our church. The heart of man is in your hand. Always give us a heart for your people and a heart for you. And God, we just thank you for this day. This is a day that you have made. And because you allowed us to be part of your day, we shall rejoice and be glad about it. And we bless you now. In our big brother Jesus' name, thank you, Father. Amen, amen. Will you clap your hands for the Lord? Amen. While you're standing, just one scripture we'll read. Psalms 42, verse 11. Psalms 42, verse 11. The psalmist declared, "Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him, who is the health of my countenance and my God." You may be seated. Hallelujah. Come on, will you praise God for the young adult today? You are the living word. Bless God. Amen. Thank God for each of you this morning. God bless Pastor Davis and Jackie. Good to have you back, Jack. Amen. Good to see you, baby. Thank God for Pastor Bubba and Sheena. Amen. Thank God for them. To all the elders and ministers and you, the people of God, to our district missionary and Supervisor Ellis and Bra Ellis, amen. And thank God for our deacon brothers and just the people of God here on today. Amen. It's a good day to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. God's been good to us, hasn't he? Will you testify to somebody and tell them God's been good to me? He's been good to me. More than you or this world could ever be. He dries all of my tears away. Turn my midnights into day. So I'm gonna say, thank you, Lord. Come on. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. Let's put a thank you, Lord, on that. While the children make their way to children's church. Children, make your way to children's church. Put a thank you, Jesus, on it. In the balcony, could you put a thank you, Jesus? I won't complain. I just want to tell you thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank God again on this Palm Sunday. When the king is riding in as a servant, he's coming to town as a servant, riding on a donkey. Amen. And God bless. Amen. God bless each of you on today. Thank God again for just being here. We thank God. Do we have any guests with us for the first time today that's here for the... Stand up. Stand up, guests. Wow. Come on, y'all. Let's welcome our guests. let's welcome our guest. We say, so glad you're here. How do you do? God loves you. We love you too. Will someone take a moment and tell our guests thank you and thank them for worshiping with us on this morning? Amen. You just didn't come to another church service, but you've come to a worship experience. Amen. And I praise God for all of you, the people of the Lord. I praise God for the young adults on the day. Will you thank God for Chris and Jacoya? Amen. Leaders of our young adult with Pam and Robin. We're certainly praying for Pam and Robin. Their aunt is funeralizing their aunt on yesterday. Good to see the shoemaker, Dick. Good to see you, Dick. Sister Shoemaker, good to see you. God's good to you. God's good to you, amen. You're looking good, Doc. Amen. You're looking good. Y'all looking good. Amen. Praise God for you all. Listen, let me quickly, and again, Sarah, awesome. Awesome. She said, I ain't like no preacher. And then she went, well, I don't know. Yeah, a little something there, Sarah. Amen. Woman of God. Your eyes glow with glory. She know who she is in God. You know, but we going to hear from her the next youth Sunday. She's going to do she's going to do a 7:45 message. She'll be preaching at 7:45. That's who she is. That's who she is. So I just done put you out there. She's so old. How old are you, 23? Oh, my God. She has an old soul. And she's an anointed young lady. Oh, my God. Her dad is anointed, her mom and her grandparents. And we praise God for her. Listen, on next month, the 28th, April 28th, that's the fourth Sunday. We have the Chosen event in April. Fourth Sunday in April is our Chosen event. We are adopting children. Well, no, a child is going to adopt us. Where at, Ross? What country? Out of Uganda. We're working with World Vision. And our mission, stand up, Ross, J.D. Ross. There are some children that's looking for parents. A lot of children all over the world need help. And, you know, we try to help our own community. We got food pantry here. We here at Peter's Rock, we have a food pantry. We help people with their light bill, gas bill. We support foreign countries as well. So we are broad. We are broader than just Starkville and Mississippi. But we're in foreign countries. There's a church right now in Nigeria, Showers of Blessing, who watches every Sunday. Bless you, Bishop Lucky. We help Kenya, where Supervisor Ellis, Assistant Supervisor in Kenya. We support there, and we've helped Peru. And now there's a children need adoption. Well, they're going to adopt us, and I'm going to adopt too. How many names we got, Ross? We got about 12 people say, hey, I'll adopt a child. And what you do is you pay $39 a month for their clothing and schooling. And he's gonna, after that service, he's gonna get on the plane, go off, take a 21-hour flight to Uganda and meet the children and put your pictures up. And the children are gonna say, I want him to be my dad. That's me. And then I'll be supporting. I'm gonna adopt two children at $39 a month. And I hope anybody here want to tag on to that. And they're going to pick you. Then the next Sunday, he's coming back. And he's bringing pictures. And he's bringing pictures of your child. And anytime you want to stop it, you can stop. It's, you know, but I think it's just a way to go beyond the walls. Amen. So anybody else, raise your hand. Raise, stand up. Say, let me see what we got here. Let me see. Praise God. Because I'm saying, God, I'm believing God for 50 people. Two, three, four. Put their name. I'm believing God for 50 people that would adopt, let a child adopt them. You know, and when I told him, I said, I'm believing Peter's Rock for 50. You know, the lady told me, I see 100. I said, okay, I'll go in your faith, but I'm open my mouth for 50. So we're going to do that. And every month on the fourth Sunday, fourth Wednesday, we've been doing series. And I want to thank God for Elder Wilson, Elder Dorsey, Elder Ross. And but on the fourth, starting the fourth Wednesday night in April, I want to call it family night. And we start at 6 o'clock, but I want you to bring your whole family. Husband, wife, children, bring the grandchildren if you want. And I'll be teaching family series. Yeah. And then we're going to feed you. So on that Wednesday night, you ain't got to worry about cooking. We're going to feed the family. Now, we're going to have one of the meals you got to belch and, you know, stuff after. But we have enough for you to go home and know you've been fed. But that's starting April 24th, that we're going to bring everybody, family, husband, wife, grandchildren, bring mama, you know, but I want to talk to the family. Amen? Amen? Amen. And then on the day, I got to go to Reform, Alabama, and whatever choir going to go with us, we're going to leave about 1:15. I want to talk, and I tell you, that Chris like to carry, that Chris, you do a good job, Chris, carrying the service. He does a good job. I want to thank God for the minds of all the college students. Stand up. That's you today, college students. Stand up. Thank God. Hey, Brooke. Bree. Come here, girl. Come give me a hug. Y'all, this is Bree. This is my other Cabbage Patch daughter. Come here, Bree. Run, child. Run, child. Y'all, well, y'all appreciate Bree. Love you, baby. Thank you. That's my other Cabbage Patch daughter. I mean, Bree and Brooke. Stand up, Brooke. She was a weightlifting champ in high school in Mississippi. I think she holds a record in weightlifting. Three. Whoever she married better look out. Like, man, messing me up. So proud of you, baby. Amen. So proud. I want to talk this morning, and I'm not going to be long. Young adults, they're going to feed the young adults. Good to see all my children. About when my emotions conflict with my devotion. Emotion versus devotion. Yeah. Sometimes our emotion can mess with our devotion. But we always, it's important that we always stay devoted to God. Psalms 42 in the Message Bible says this: why are you down in the dumps, dear soul? Why are you crying the blues? Fix my eyes on God. Soon I'm praising again. He puts a smile on my face. He's my God. Common English Bible says it like this. Why, I ask myself, are you so depressed? Why are you so upset inside? Hope in God? Because I will again give him thanks. My saving presence and my God. It's interesting to know that Psalms 42 begins what is known as a new book in Psalm, because the first 41 Psalms was Psalms of David. But now we have this Psalm penned by the sons of Korah. It starts off with a visual of a deer panting for the water brooks, which helps us understand the zeal and the longing that we ought to have for the Lord. Just as a deer needs the streams of water for survival and pants for those refreshing waters, our souls should long for God. And the thirst should be so strong, and the thirst was so strong, he asked, when can I go and meet with God? Is there anybody thirsty for more of God? Can I admit, Lord, I'm not there yet, but I thirst for you. Because more of God means less of me. This leads us to see how the psalmist, he's expressing his emotions, his feelings. Yet no matter how he felt, at the end of the psalm, he speaks to his soul. He speaks to his emotions. I want to tell somebody right now, you need to talk to your emotions. You need to tell your emotions, stop. Line up with the will of God. Line up my emotion with the word of God. Understand, and Brian is teaching a series that there's a three-part triune of man. And he's teaching it. He'll finish it on Wednesday night. 1 Thessalonians 5:23, and when Paul told him, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly, or wholly, completely. And I pray, God, your spirit, your soul, and your body, the three parts of man, be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Well, you see, our souls is made up of the mind. Is that what you told us? The will and our emotions. Sometimes you just got to speak to your emotions. Especially when it's trying to take you from the will of God. We can say the soul is the carrier of our emotions. Our emotions can be feelings. Feelings. Nothing but feelings. Feelings on the inside. Sometimes these feelings are caused by pain, but they can also be caused by pleasure. But that the purpose sometimes of negative emotions is to move us in a direction away from God. The devil can work on our negative emotions. He'll have you thinking people don't like you, and the fact is they're not even studying you. He can have you thinking somebody's saying something about you and they weren't even talking about you. All of us have dealt with what I call negative emotions. Look at a neighbor and say, you done dealt with negative emotions. There's been sadness. There's been anger. 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 Loneliness. Jealousy. Self-criticism, fear, rejection. And I'm telling you, those emotions can be difficult and sometimes even painful. Then there are some positive emotions like happiness, joy, excitement, gratitude, and love. This is the reason why it's important, beloved, that we got to gain control of all those negative emotions we display. Because sometimes we display negative emotions. You ain't got to tell me what you're thinking. You showing it. If we allow negative emotions to control, have control of us, then we'll move away from the will, the plan, and the purpose of God for our life. Here it is. You can sit in worship angry, feeling ill against somebody. Your emotions got you frustrated sitting in worship. Angry trying to worship. Our emotions have us at a war when God said, I want worship. We got to move from warring in worship to true worship. That means I got to tell my emotions I got to line up with the will of God. I might have walked in, me and Chloe might have had an argument come to church, but when I get to church, I can't let nothing, I can't let nobody hinder my devotion to God. I got to give him praise. I got to clap my hand. I got to say thank you, Jesus. I got to lift my hand. I can't let my emotions drive my devotion, but I'm going to tell my devotion not to drive my emotions. I'm yet going to praise God. I'm yet going to give him glory. I'm yet going to call on his name. I'm yet going to bless the name of the Lord. Notice in the text, the psalmist's emotion was about to defeat his devotion. Tell somebody, don't let your emotions defeat your devotion. But you know what he did? He had to talk to himself. Sometimes you got to walk here talking to yourself. You mad, but get over it right quick because you got to go talk to God. You got to talk to yourself. You might not feel it, but when you're getting there, you better feel something. Because I don't want to come to church and leave the way I came. I might have walked in here down, dumped, and depressed. All in my emotion. But when I leave out of here, I thank God I'm still here. I thank God I didn't go crazy when that happened to me. I thank God I didn't slap nobody. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. When you walk out of here, you ought to walk out different. You ought to walk out and say, I give God praise. I could have lost my mind. I give God praise. I could have went to jail. I give God praise. Will you give him praise now? Will you look at him and say, don't let your emotions defeat your devotion. Tell him, stay devoted to God. Give God your best. Give God the best you got. Give God, don't let nothing hold your praise hostage. Don't let nobody hold your praise hostage. You got a right to praise God. You got a right to give God glory. You got a right. Oh. I'm about done. Sometimes you got to talk to yourself. Why are you just sitting there? Your emotions everywhere. Just sitting there. Thinking. I don't feel like praising. Y'all don't know how mad I am. I don't feel like praying. Me and this girl just had an argument. On our way to church. I don't feel it. But you got to talk to yourself.
Yes, sir.
If it had not been for the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Come on, Pastor.
In spite of all that I've been through.
Yes, sir.
You got to talk to yourself. And tell your emotions. I woke up this morning.
Yes, sir.
Got out of bed. In my right mind. And may I submit to you. It wasn't the devil that told you to come to church. The devil wanted you to stay home. But since you're here, you're going to say, God, I'm going to give you praise. God. So, please be seated. Let me. The psalmist's emotions was about to defeat his devotion. Yeah. But he talked to himself. Tell your neighbor, sometimes you got to talk to yourself to get you out of that mode. Get you out of that dark place. There are folks watching me at home this morning. You're in a dark place, but the reason you're there, you ain't talked yourself out of it. You waiting for somebody to talk you out of it. And the God says, I've given you the power to get yourself out of it. Can I give you one remedy? Just start praising God like everything's all right. Just start giving God glory like you got money in the bank. Just start praising God like you own the business. Oh! Hallelujah. And Paul asked, the psalmist asked himself, why are you downcast? So, why are you so disturbed within me? Why are you getting so depressed? You sitting in here depressed right now. Get out that dark place. Tell yourself, self, we out of here. Now give God praise. Come on out of it. Come on out of it. Come on out of it. Talk to your emotions. Talk to your emotions. And watch God do the rest. Talk to your emotions. I'm going to clap my hand. I'm going to stand up. I'm going to turn around. I'm going to shake it. I'm just going to do. I'm give God something. He's been good to me. He blessed me. He delivered me. He saved me. You're dealing with hurt. Negative emotions. You're dealing with frustration. You're dealing with oppression. Suffering. And it's causing you to become skeptical about what God is going to do for you. God wants you to know he didn't bring you this far to leave you now. Will you shake a neighbor's hand and tell him, he didn't bring me this far to leave me now. So the psalmist, he took control over his emotion through his devotion. He says, hope in God. When you look at a neighbor and say, don't lose your hope. He said, hope in God. I have an expectation that everything is going to be all right. I got an expectation it's going to work out after a while. I got an expectation. Weeping endure for a night. That's one emotion. But on the flip side, joy. Somebody shout joy. Joy comes in the morning. Will you give God some praise? He's speaking to his emotion. He's not allowing the negative emotions to dictate his mind. He's going to keep his feelings in check. Tell somebody, sometimes you got to put your feelings in check. I got to tell myself, stop acting the fool. Have anybody been there? I got to tell myself, stop acting ugly. I got to tell myself, stop acting like you ain't saved. I got to tell myself, you got to praise God again. You got to trust God again. You got to believe God again. You got to know that God got you on his mind. God got you tattooed on his hand. God. He put his feelings in check. He said, I got to keep my hope in the Lord. I can't let my emotions destroy or hinder my devotion. I'm going to make my devotion dictate my emotion. I'm going to say, my soul loves Jesus. Why are my emotions trying to run off with me? Just my imagination running away with me. But I'm going to speak to my soul. Come on back, imagination. We're going to trust in God. I'm imagining me getting fired. I'm imagining me going through divorce. I'm imagining me having financial difficulties. But the devil is alive. I declare and decree, I'm going to bring my emotions back and tell myself, I trust God. I believe God. I may not have my money now, but I'm going to praise Him till my money comes. I may not have my spouse, but I'm going to praise God till my spouse show up. Yeah! Shout yes! Look at somebody and say, maintain a devotion to God. That state of being dedicated. That state of being consecrated. That state of being set apart for God's purpose. Our devotion is a solemn attention to God in worship. Having a yielded heart and some affections to God. With reverence, prayer, and meditation. My affection to God. Oh, Lordy, I can't keep quiet sometime. I can't keep my mouth shut sometime. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, my righteous emotions get stirred. When I think of where He brought me from, when I think of what He done for me, my righteous emotions, they get stirred. Well, my negative emotions, I say, just sit there. My negative emotions, I say, ain't nothing gonna work out. My negative emotions, just hand me down and depressed. But I speak to my emotions. Emotions line up with devotion. Emotions, we gonna praise God. I'ma praise Him with my hand. I'ma praise Him with my mouth. I'm gonna praise Him in a dance. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually. I submit to you devotion. Somebody shout devotion. Look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, sometimes my emotion try to distract me from my devotion, but I'm declaring for the rest of my life, my devotion will always be priority. My devotion to God, to holiness, to righteousness, my devotion, yes, shout yes. Devotion, our external worship to God must never cease, no matter what you're going through, no matter what happened in your life. Your external worship to God must never cease. You got to be determined to walk with Jesus. You got to be determined to follow Jesus all the way. Somebody shout all the way. Is there anybody in here have a made up mind? I'm determined to go with Jesus all the way. Well, you're sick about two people saying and say, I am determined when my emotions get crazy. I'm yet determined when I can't see my way. I'm yet determined. I'm going with Jesus. I'm going with Jesus. I'm going with Jesus. I'm going with Jesus. I'ma stay with Jesus. I'ma hold on. Yeah. So the psalmist is feeling like his soul is downcast. And the waves of life is sweeping over him. And he cries out to God. He said, wait, have you forgotten me? He's been depressed by his enemies. And in the midst of the suffering, he's enduring taunting words from people that don't like him. And the enemy continues to say to him, where's your God? Have you ever been overcome by emotions? I'm talking about dealing with your spiritual life. People got you so upset, your emotions made you talk about them. Caused you to feel animosity. When emotions told you to quit, don't even go back down there. And don't even realize here's where you got your blessing. Your emotions will talk to you, tell you to leave him or go and hurt somebody else. But because you love God, your devotion spoke over your emotion. Can anybody say, I love God? My soul loves Jesus. Bless his name. Look at his mind and tell him, my soul loves Jesus. My emotions really love Jesus. Sometimes they just get out of whack, but I want to bring them back in. I'm going to give God some praise. I'm going to give God some glory. I'm going to thank him for where he brought me from. I'm going to thank him for what he's done for me. I need you to clap your hands and give God some praise. The text let us know that the psalmist is speaking from experience and is teaching us by telling us about his life and how he got through his difficulties. I want you to know, my brothers and my sisters, life is not easy when you feel overwhelmed. Life is not easy when you feel forgotten. Life is hard when you feel that God has completely forgotten you while you're being struck down by people. What should we do in the midst of those emotions? Rather than keeping, focus on himself, the psalmist turns his attention to the Lord. He calls on God. He said, let your light and your truth, let them guide me. He offers a beautiful call of dependence upon God to guide him through what he's going through. It's always important for us to keep our eyes on God. Shake a neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, keep your eyes on God. If you got troubles, keep your eyes on God. If you're disappointed, keep your eyes on God. Don't allow your emotions to take you to despair. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes, yes, shout yes. Our feelings, our emotion can sometimes warp our sense of right and wrong. It can change them to where innocent people, we can hurt innocent people. We can push ourselves away from the hand of God. Our emotions many times are tied to what we desire or what we feel we need. And when we don't get those desires or when those needs are not fulfilled, we let the negative emotion show on the outside. And when your negative emotions show on the outside, it does not reflect the love of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In our text, the psalmist, he did not let his emotions get the best of him. He closes the psalm by saying, emotions, why you're down in a dump, dear soul? Why you're crying? You got the blues. He said, fix your eyes. And if you fix your eyes on Jesus, you're going to get your praise back. If you fix your eyes on Jesus, you're going to get your anointing back. If you fix your eyes on Jesus, Jesus will fix it. Yes, yes. Don't let your emotions, your anger, your being annoyed, your frustration, your hurt by somebody or something happen to you that'll cause you to lose your devotion that'll cause you to lose your dedication to the God of your salvation. Will you shake a neighbor's hand and say, stay devoted to your God? Tell them, stay devoted. Look at two or three people. Point at them and say, stay devoted. Jesus, Jesus understands the battle we have between our emotions and our devotion. Jesus, he understands the battle between our emotions and our devotion. Over 2,000 years ago, oh Lordy, after he rode into Jerusalem, they laid palms in the path. They were crying, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. They took Jesus. He went to the upper room. He had supper with his disciples. Oh, Lordy. Oh, Lordy. That was on a Thursday. But let me just interject here. That was on a Thursday. But what the devil didn't know, Sunday was coming. Will you take a neighbor's hand? Say, Sunday's coming. Oh, Lordy. Not this Sunday, but Sunday's coming. Yes. Resurrection's coming. Lord have mercy. He ate there. He went out in the garden. He took Peter, James, and John, his inner circle. They got out in the garden. And when they got there in the garden, thank you, son, he kneeled down to pray. He prayed a little bit, prayed an hour. He went back to where the disciples was. They were sleeping. He said, why are you sleeping? I'm over here going through. Why are you sleeping? He said, well, go ahead. He goes back and pray again. And when he prayed, his emotions tried to interfere with his devotion. But he let his devotion take charge. He said, Father, Father, I know you can do it. Let this cup pass from me. That was the emotions. But devotion kicked in. Devotion said, not my will, not my will. Devotion came back in. Not my will, but thy will be done. Yes, yes. When he went back to the disciples, he said, sleep on now. I'm all right now, because my devotion got me out of my emotions. I come to tell somebody, you ought to praise God. You ought to magnify. Look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, don't let your emotions hinder your devotion. Praise him while you can. Magnify.
Hallelujah. Come on and praise him out of your emotion. Come on, give God praise in this place. Come on, lift up your voice and give God praise. Hallelujah. I will not let my emotions get the best of me. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Man. Hallelujah. I ain't gonna let you ought to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, neighbor, I'm moving from this place. If you came in here today in your emotions, there's a song, H-Town say, emotion make you cry sometime, but most of all, it'll do what? Make you fall in love. I'm gonna say it like this, emotion may make you cry sometime, but devotion will make you fall in love with none other than Jesus Christ in himself. So if you can get to that place where I need that devotion, amen? We're standing all over the building, but you came in here emotional. You was an emotional wreck. But somewhere in the midst, you lost your devotion. Somewhere in the mix. And you got to understand what the enemy, what he's trying to do. The first thing he's going to attack is your mind. and you're going to get all emotional, and you're going to make emotional decisions. Our decisions need to be made based off our devotion. So I'm going to ask the altar workers, would they come? Because there's some of you that is in an emotional train wreck. If you don't come out of there today, ain't no telling where you going. You will not leave here the way you came. Because somebody is going to stand and agree with you today. Bible says where two or three are joined together, in my name, there I am also. So you need to come from where you are. You know that's you. I've been in an emotional train wreck. Borderline suicidal. The devil will not win. I'm getting my devotion back. I don't let nobody, I don't care what nobody says, how they looking at you, what they're going to think about you. You need to move and let somebody pray with you. We may need some more altar workers. Somebody need to pray with you. You may need to cry. That's my emotions. That's natural. But discipline says I need to get back to devotion. My natural self, I'm gonna cry. But discipline says I need to get back to Christ. Come on. Oh, glory. You gonna help Faye?
God wants to heal you everywhere you hurt. Everywhere.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
God will see you through. He'll take the pain away. God shall provide for you each and every day. Lift your hands and say, God will be you when we rock. Everywhere you hurt, God will see you through. He'll take away. God shall provide for you each and every day. Just lift your head and say, God, I need you.
This time I want you to breathe in.
I need you right away.
Hold it.
Right.
Come on. God want to hear you. Hallelujah. Ah, ba 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 ba. Miss this opportunity. You cannot miss this opportunity. Touch them where they hurt at, God. Touch them where the pain is. Do it right now. God, under the sound of my voice, move in this place.
Each and every day.
Yes.
Lift your hands and say,
come on, sing that. Sing
God,
that.
I need
yes,
you.
Yes.
I need you right.
God, oh, come to me. I need you, I come to thee. I need thee, oh, I need thee. And every hour I need thee.
Us right now, God. Pastor. Hallelujah.
Bless me, God.
Hallelujah.
Bless me, God.
The Spirit of the Lord is moving in this place.
Bless me, God.
And I hear the word surrender. I hear the word surrender. Some of you hadn't surrendered yet. I hear surrender. Surrender yourself. Surrender now. Babababas. 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 Tadadadadabas. Ekorobashata. Yadadadabas. Shukorobashata. Lift your hands up. E kanadadadabas. E korobashata. E edobasi. E korobashata. Surrender, baby. Surrender. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Power now, God. E korobashata. Surrender it. Surrender. E bababas. Surrender it to God. Surrender now. Do it, God. Do it, God. Do it, God. Move now by your power. Hey, Koroba Shata. Hey, da 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 basio. Hey, ka da 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 basio. Shata da 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 basio. Shata da 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 basio. Hey, Koroba Shata. Hey, Shata da 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 basio. Hey, Koroba Shata da 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 basio. Hey, do it, God. Move right now by your power, God. Move right now. Move right now. I hear the word surrender. Surrender now. Is there anybody else that say, I need to surrender? I'm ready to surrender. I'm tired. I'm tired of my emotions getting the best of me. I'm tired of my emotions getting the best of me. Come here now. That's it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You will not leave the way you came. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands up. Surrender, baby. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And we give you glory right now.
Working, you know, doing solar work, but the solar farm that I was working on, it kind of had safety issues, so they shut the whole farm down, and I was getting ready to go back to Georgia, but, you know, as I was headed back to the bus station, something just told me don't go back, you know, because it's bad down there. I just lost a brother last week while I was up here, and I didn't even get to go back to the funeral, and it kind of bothers me, but it's okay. You know, because I felt like God had something more in store for me here. So, you know, I stayed, was looking for a job. I was staying with a guy here, a friend who was doing the same thing. You know, I stayed and, you know, stayed with him for 2 weeks, but I knew I couldn't stay with him and his family for long, so I had to figure out something. So, you know, I went to Popeye's, just tried to get on, just grab something quick, and you know, they gave me a job within a few days, so I'm working there right now. I've been here only a month, and I done had 2 interviews since then, you know, just trying to make the best do. Instead of going back to Georgia, I'm just trying to make the best do and so I can get my kids up here. That's all I really, you know, that's all I pray about and try to get done. But I just appreciate this church because I've walked by about 4 or 5 weeks straight since I've been here, and I see all the spirits and everybody walking in, and some just told me today to just come over here, put some clothes on, come over here, and I'm kind of glad I did because it kind of touched me.
It's going to work out, Cortez. Will you praise God that things are going to work? Oh, bless me now. Thee. Hallelujah. Praise God, this young man gave his life to the Lord. Oh! Yay! Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh! I need some praises. I wish the saints would praise God.
Thank you.
By his goodness. Emotions. Come on, get your devotion back. I'm going to praise God. I'm going to love on God. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on. Get your devotion back. Shout out to God of praise. Ah, hallelujah. Glory to his name. As you get your devotion back, you ought to shout unto God a praise. Get your devotion back. Say that I come to serve you. Notice, I'm getting my devotion back. I'm getting my devotion back. I come to serve Satan. Notice that I'm getting my devotion back. You will not win. You will not win. Order is being structured, and you shall not win. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. 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 We say glory to his name. Glory to his name. Yeah. Shout out glory. Glory. Glory to his name. Yeah. 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 Glory. Ba-ba-ba-ba-bas. We gotta move on in service, but the Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is moving. The Spirit of the Lord is moving. The Spirit of the Lord is moving. Glory! Yeah. Glory! And we thank you now, Jesus. And we give you praise. And we give you praise. And we give you praise. And we give you glory. Shh. Come on, I need some worshipers in here. I need some praises in here. I need some praises in here. I need some worshipers. Can you shout glory? Have your way, God. Have your way, God. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. My God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. Hey, you ought to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I won today. Because my emotion will not get the best of me. Hallelujah. Come on and clap your hands all over the building. As you give God praise, come on, one last time, would you shout unto God a praise? Hallelujah, because you are victorious. You have won today. My emotions do not get the best of me, and I shall have my devotion today. Hallelujah. And we thank God. Come on, thank God for the messenger on today. Let's give it up for our pastor, Superintendent Joseph Hawkins. Come on, say amen for him. What a word. Pastor, we pray for your strength today. We thank you for the message, that it has brought healing and deliverance. Deliverance in the mind. For God haven't given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. That's what we're leaving here with today. Say amen as pastor.
Come on. Thank you. Thank you, Tripp. Will you just lift your hand again? Just lift your hand. It's going to be all right. Past Sunday, 4 years ago, Glow went into the hospital. 4 years ago. And she didn't come out. That was Sunday, 4 years ago. Tuesday, 29 years ago, I was assigned to Peter's Rock. I had a 29, anybody 29 years old? 29? Who 29? Okay, nobody 29? Y'all missed $29. Paula said, I'm 29, 92. But 29 years ago, Tuesday, the third Sunday in March, I was assigned to Peter's Rock. Remember that, Annie? And on the 17th, Brother Reddick, Glow went in the hospital. Both of us had COVID. And on April the 3rd, my dad, my mentor, Bishop T.T. Scott, transitioned. And on April the 20th, Glow transitioned. On April the 13th this year, we would have been married 50 years. Amen. So I thank God for my babies. For Dee Dee and Darius sticking with Dad, and Shay and Baylen, JJ, and I thank God for my family. Y'all ain't nothing like family. Love on your family. I told them I can't wait till our next trip together. Amen. And thank God, I call him my children's brother, because they talk to him more than they talk to me, and they tell him what to tell me. As Brother Josh, who serves as my chief of staff, and he does an awesome job. That's my chief of staff. Sheena did it, but we didn't have a title for it, but now Bubba do it. And thank y'all, Peter Rock, for celebrating with me 29 years. We've come a long way. We saw some mothers come and go. But today, it's been on my heart. Mother Martin's transition, I prayed about it. And I know I talked to God. I talked with Helen, talked with Margie. And today, I want to appoint our new church mother. I want Rena Abrams to come. Come here, baby. Will y'all praise God for Mother Rena? She has been such a supporter to me. Don't hate, don't be jealous. She support everywhere I go. Her and Dot is right there with me. And I saw her one Sunday. I don't know if y'all was here. She was walking the aisles with her hand lifted. Anybody remember that? And the Lord spoke to say, that's your mother. And I want to thank God for Mother Rena. I was going to wait, but I said, I can't do it. You know, I'm Church of God in Christ. I can't hold nothing. Rena, thank you, baby. Amen. I love you. I mean, she ride and die with me. Support. Tell me off. But with respect. Nothing ugly. And God spoke to my heart and said, that's Peter's Rock mother. She can't relate. It don't matter what you want to talk about. You want to talk trash? She can talk trash too. What you want to talk about? Anything you want to talk about. She got experience. She's been married, had children. And she's the third oldest person here. Rena, mother, Carlinda's sister, mother, she's the oldest. She's 90. Then Liza is 90. It's 80. And Rena turns 80 in August. And would you serve with me, Rena?
Yes.
I love you, baby.
I love you too.
I want to thank God for Helen and for Margie. I know Margie wasn't expecting this, but I'm doing it today. And come here, Helen. She has two assistants to help her. That's Helen, Mother Moore, and Mother Wilkins. And we'll meet. I want to meet with the three of you sometime to carry this, to carry the work and help me tend to these sweet mothers. Peter Rock got some sweet women here. And I thank God for this one right here. Amen. She's about to turn 80. I'm turning 70. And I cannot keep up with her and Dot. They always on the road. Clark's there. Everywhere I've been, I had to preach one Friday night in Alabama. They was in Alabama with me. Greenville, Grenada, Columbus. She right there. You know, and not only that, but sometimes she asks me, you want me to drive you? Mama, come on. She got a lead foot too. But we'll be talking some more, baby. Will y'all congratulate our mother? Turn around, baby. Turn around. Y'all greet her. Y'all want to greet mama? Oh, bless me now. My say. Come on, Evan. Don't leave me, baby. I come. I need
test.
Every hour, oh. I need thee. Oh, 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 bless. My
you, Jesus.
When it's dark, dark and weary in my life, God, I know I can come to you. Oh, soul, why are you disquieting me? Oh, soul, I won't let you be quiet in me. But I come with my praise, I come with my worship, I come. Tears in my eyes, I come.
Jesus.
To I say. Lord, yes. Yes.
Yes. Glory to your name, Jesus.
Yes, Lord, yes.
Hallelujah.
I surrender it all, yes. I surrender it all, yes. I come to the God.
Yes, God. As the mother lay hands on our children.
Bless,
man, thank God for the mother.
Me now.
Thank you, God, for the mother. Thank you for our mother. Thank you, God. What a beautiful moment. Glory to your name, God. Nothing like a mother's love and her teaching. Thank God for our church mother. Speak to me, mother. Of the church. Thank you, God, for the obedience, Pastor. We see the structure. Peter's Rock, we're going. We got work to do.
Yes, Lord.
And now structure has been put in place.
We have the head, our pastor, Superintendent Joseph Hawkins. Our district missionary, Missionary Young. And to our new elect, Mother Rena Abram. Glory. Thank you for your obedience. Mama, feel free. That's your seat. And as pastor, and this is Missionary Young's seat. Pastor, that's your seat. And we're so glad. It may just be a seat to y'all, but we are so glad that y'all have taken your place. Now, we're moving up. You ought to put a praise on it right there. Peter's Rock, we're moving up to the next level. My God. Thank God. So wonderful. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful Palm Sunday. Amen. Glory to his name. We're getting ready to receive our offering from our leader, Superintendent Hawkins. He was standing in the center aisle. We're asking all tithers, would you stand in the middle aisle? All tithers, would you line up in the center aisle? Our pastor, I think, man, we got, I hear your pastor used to say this, help me stay saved. Don't mess with my pastor. I think we have the best, I don't think I know, we have the best pastor on this side of heaven. He'll stand and he's going to receive the tithes. I'm asking all tithers, would you line up in the center aisle? If you have a liberal offering, would you get that in your right hand? And would you please too stand? Peter's Rock is so blessed, and I'm so glad that I and my family can be a part. And if you're not a part of Peter's Rock, Pastor says this, to be a part, take a part. So if you haven't taken a part and you want to be a part, do so. Do so whatever your hands find good. Father, we thank you right now for the tithers. We thank you, God, for their obedience in giving their tithes. And Father, I pray right now, special blessing, Lord, that you'll open up the windows of heaven and you'll pour out a blessing where they don't have room enough to receive it all. God, that you enlarge their territories. You increase right now, God. Father, help in whatever need it is, whatever the need may be, you know, God. But Father, I pray that you see their hearts in their giving. I pray for everybody that's given an offering today, God, whether it's a sacrifice, a seed, whatever it is, Lord, you see it as a seed. And I pray that you return it back to them 100-fold. Or whatever the need may be. It is in Jesus' name we pray. This in Jesus' name. Amen. We're coming. And we have Christy that's in the vestibule taking debit or credit card.
expecting God for increase. Hallelujah. And now our announcements.
Host an Autism Awareness Initiative luncheon. This luncheon will provide nonverbal awareness, introduce local authorities, police, fire, 911, MEMA, reduce the likelihood of a tragic event happening with anyone with autism. So we want your support in coming out, making this event a special one. Our marriage ministry is hosting a special fundraiser and we need your help. It's a calendar fundraiser. This is simply how it goes. You pick a day and you pay for that day. So if it's the 8th, you pay $8. If it's the 15th, you pay $15. You get it? For bonus days, you can choose the amount you would like to pay. To support, please see the tapes or any members of the marriage ministry. We are offering CPR classes, including basic CPR, choking, AED with the instructor, Fire Chief Cheese Yarbrough of the Starkville Fire Department. Certificates will be awarded to those who complete the course. The fee is only $10 per person. This will happen on March 30th at 10 o'clock a.m. Everyone is invited to participate, Peters Rock members and the community. You are never too old or too young to make a difference in saving a life. Our very own Missy Coates will share the gospel in song at this year's Rhythm of Gospel Awards. It will be held June 19th through 23rd in Mobile, Alabama. Peters Rock, she's asking for your support. The Education Department is asking for everyone to donate 2 to 3 bags of candy for the children. This is for Easter Sunday. The deadline for donations is March 24th. If you cannot give candy, you can also make a monetary contribution to help out on the cost. Again, this for the Education Department. Brother Stillman and Hazel Shoemaker would like to extend their gratitude and thanks for the prayer, support, calls, and money as Brother Stillman underwent surgery. He wants you to know he is thankful for each and every one of you. I Love My Church campaign 2024. We're asking everyone for a $300 contribution towards the I Love My Church campaign this year. At this time, welcome Missionary Teresa Rogers and the Sister to Sister Women's Ministry with a special presentation.
Good morning, good morning. It's been a beautiful, beautiful day. March cannot entail all of the great things that women have done throughout the year. But it was set aside by Congress to appreciate the milestones that women made naturally and spiritually. And here at Peters Rock, our women ministry, we just took this month to just appreciate so many different things. We appreciate our church mothers, former, we appreciate the educators, single mothers, and on Friday night, we were appreciating everyone. And as we close this Sunday, just for Women's History Month, we want to appreciate every woman. We have so many women that's made so many milestones. I thought about our own Sister Paula, Sister Dorothy Tate, we call Lazarus, that's been at the death door so many times. We have so many people that's made so many milestones. But as I was getting ready for today, a couple of weeks ago, we had our staff meeting, and I was telling them, I kept hearing God say, Moses, Moses. And Teresa, remember who praised me when they came out of Egypt. And he began to remind me of what he gave Pastor for our theme, in a sense, for this year. We've been here long enough. So I want to ask all of the women to stand with your tambourine. Those that didn't get one, we kind of ran out. But if all of the women would please stand. The Bible says in Exodus, as the children of Israel had came across the Red Sea, And after they came across the Red Sea and they knew God had blessed them, they left some things in Egypt that hindered them, physical things, but their mind was still there. So this morning, as we leave this place, the things that had you bound in Egypt mentally, you're leaving it there. And we as women, we sound the tamarind. I call Sister Margie, and she's watching. She's got her pot and her spoon as her tamarind. I tried to get her a tamarind. The Bible says Miriam, the sister of Moses, began to strike out her tamarind. Could I hear your tamarinds, ladies? And they began to give God praise because Moses had led them from that place. And as symbolically as just hearing God, and I fight, but I thank God for his confirmation. If you would pass me that, please, Landers. The Lord told me to get a replica of a staff and give it to Pastor today. This morning, Kendrick talked about Moses. I sat there and said, God, I just need you to help me to get out of my mind of wrestling with your voice. Then Pastor mentioned it, and God said, I'm going to give you one more confirmation. And Tripp said, it's time for us to move from this place. So out of obedience, Pastor, I want you to know the women stand with you. And I give you this as you hear God to lead us from this place. On Friday night, the Lord told me to have the women to go from light to light as he prophesied through you for the church. To go over to the property and stand. And he would give it to us, the land will yield what belongs to us. So this day, as we move from this place, as things are in alignment, God said his son, continue to hear him. Watch your mouth against Moses. Watch your mouth against Moses, my God. But this staff is replica of what God had given you on the inside. And every time you feel like it's crazy, remember God said, I'm your walking stick just like you spoke that Sunday. So women, shout with your tambourine as we move from this place. God bless you.
Chris.
Amen. Thank you, Missionary Rogers. On next Sunday, we will have our Resurrection Sunday worship experience. On next Sunday, it's the fifth Sunday, that worship experience will take place at 7:45 and 10 o'clock. And also, all young adults and youth, our regional youth rally is coming up in Memphis, and we are looking to take you all. So if you're interested in going, please see myself, Sister Kenitra, any of the youth members or young adult leaders to prepare for that. Thank you.
Amen. Ain't no telling what you're going to get on Sunday at the Rock. You may get a concert. Or come on, say amen as our pastor come and closes out. Amen.
Thank you. Ain't no need to worry. I'm about to do a concert now. What the night is going to bring, it'll be all over in the morning. Morning, oh, it'll be all over in the morning. God bless you. I want to do something. Everybody don't have to participate. Brother Riddick, would you grab a container over there and just put that container right here, Brother Riddick? I think besides Mother Davis, Rena, where I had every Sunday. Every Sunday. I want to bless Mother. She may want to get her another hat. I want you to get a piece of change on your way out. I'm going to give $100. Come. She don't do Cash App, so get some money. You got Cash App, Rena? No, she don't do Cash App. I want you to get a piece of change. We just going to say, Rena, Mother, we love you. And that's just a little something to say, go buy your hat. All right, we love you. All right, we're standing, and on your way out, would you come and put something here? In the morning, morning, it'll be all over. Stay safe, stay strong, stay safe. God bless you. Have a good day.